A trip to the national championship game is on the line. Jones has it and hits Boston. No! Stanford is headed to the national championship game. And in the national championship game, Stanford prevailed, winning another nail biter and their first title since 1992. It is the SEC on ESPN. The holidays are here. A festive atmosphere in Columbia, South Carolina. And what better gift could you ask for than number two Stanford taking on number one South Carolina? Frambolivi ready to go, and so are we as we welcome you inside our ESPN studios here out of an abundance of caution. Ryan Rucco alongside the Hall of Famer Rebecca Lobo. So happy to be with you for what should be just a scintillating contest. Rebecca, number one team in the nation is South Carolina, 11-0. A lot of reasons why, but none bigger than Aaliyah Boston.
Yeah, Aaliyah Boston is having a player of the year type of season. The 6'5 junior center has been unstoppable at both ends of the floor, averaging 17 points, 10 rebounds a game. How's she doing it? She gets inside, 2 feet in the paint, and can finish. Can take you off the bounce. She's got it. Extended range out to three, and there are very few better at doing just this, getting to the offensive glass and finishing.
You see the numbers over the last four games, just incredible for Aaliyah Boston. 21 points, 69% shooting, 15 rebounds, and 4.5 blocks. Speaking of front court dominance, how about the incredible versatility of Haley Jones of Stanford?
Yeah, Haley Jones has done a terrific job once again as the point forward for the Stanford Cardinal, the 6'1 junior. So good at attacking the basket. She can get defensive boards and push it down the other way. Involves her teammates, 4 assists a game, gets to the glass, 8 rebounds a game. Haley Jones, once again, one of the best players in the country as well.
You see her numbers against Tennessee on Saturday. Just the ninth player with at least 15, 15, and 5 in a top 10 matchup over the last 20 seasons. Time to go to Columbia, South Carolina, where Andrea Carter is standing by.
Thanks, Ryan. Big news coming out of South Carolina. Their senior point guard, Destiny Henderson, she's missed the last 3 games with a left leg injury. She is back and will start tonight. She is not on a minutes restriction. Head coach Don Staley said that the past few games without her, they played too slow and too much in the half court. She wants more pace and less thinking on offense. Henderson should help with that.
All right, Andrea, well, no doubt Destiny Henderson, it should certainly bring some speed to South Carolina, something Dawn Staley did indeed emphasize to us earlier today. 14 straight home wins for the Gamecocks dating back to last season. They had 22 offensive rebounds in that matchup against Stanford, a 1-point win for the Cardinal to advance to the national championship game. Brink and Saxton jump it up, and South Carolina wins the tip with Henderson controlling.
You see Stanford starting out in a man-to-man defense, but they will help off of the players who do not shoot well from the perimeter try to clog up the post.
Well, one of those players, Bree Beal, Boston charges in, had a lane and able to finish. Good start for South Carolina as we take a look at the Stanford starting five.
South Carolina also picking up in their man-to-man defense. Important for Stanford to take care of the basketball. They have had issues doing that at times this season.
Haley Jones leaves it short. Rebound Beal off and pushing for South Carolina. Boston catch fire. Couldn't hit it. And the long rebound secured by jump for Stanford. Lacey Hull, who starts at the point for Stanford, threw it out, and then a turnover, just as you talked about, Rebecca.
As one of the areas that really hurt Stanford in their early season loss was to Texas, was too many turnovers.
Henderson settles things with plenty of time to operate. Nice little crossover. Beal will fire from the wing. No. Brink trying to box out, and it's going to be a foul against Brink. It'll stay right here. Dawn Staley signing a lucrative contract extension just before the start of this season, a 2017 national champion, now in her 14th season at the helm of the Gamecocks. Always stylish, too. You know, I mean, there's always something a little zesty going on with the fashion of Dawn Staley. A nice hoodie there. And Tara Vanderveer coming off a third national championship a season ago, the winningest coach in Division I history, as Boston starts with another bucket.
And important to note, Ryan, that foul on Cameron Brink. She is already out of the ball game. Ashton Prechtel in. Cameron Brink was in foul trouble the entire time against Tennessee, played limited minutes, and she's such a good shot blocker. That's going to hurt them on both ends of the floor.
Yeah, she already has six foul outs in her young career. And that's been her biggest issue, just being able to stay on the floor as Lexi Hull gets some space to finish with a left hand. And we saw Lexi really shine down the stretch of the NCAA tournament. One of the players who was able to keep her poise at moments where Stanford had trouble securing the basketball late in close games. Here they couldn't secure the rebound. That three is good.
It's important for Cook to be able to hit for a number of reasons, as you see Hull hit the mid-range jumper. Zaya Cook has been struggling the last two games with her shot confidence booster, but also it's going to make the Stanford defense extend out to the perimeter.
Yeah, shooting just 27% from the floor over her last four games. Boston deflected by Prechtel, and then that was an odd decision by Prechtel. She could have just tossed it to a teammate, instead stepped out of bounds. Tara Vanderveer in her 36th season now at the helm of Stanford. You know, we were talking about the aftermath of the national title as Boston gets blocked by Prechtel and secured by Stanford. She said last year was so strange a season that it almost still feels like a dream. Jump loves to fire from deep and hits from three.
And a jump so important to Stanford. She has been terrific for them, as you saw on that one. Deep range to extend the defense out on her as well.
The British guard became the first British woman to win an NCAA basketball championship a season ago. Offensive rebound, Saxton kicks it back out. Another chance here for South Carolina in a 7-7 game. Cook gets fouled. And free throws coming for Zaya Cook.
Remember, the women's three-point line was moved back this season. It wouldn't have mattered if it was back to NBA range. Her heels are almost on the sideline on that one, Ryan.
It's interesting because Tara Vanderveer was talking to us before the game about how she feels like that has affected certain shooters this year. Haley Jones, perhaps one of them, who started to find her stroke from three in the NCAA tournament, but has struggled now, 2 for 15 during this regular season. Jump, not affected.
Not affected at all.
Another offensive rebound. Put back won't go. Knocked out of bounds to Stanford.
South Carolina is the best offensive rebounding team in the country, already with four, including on a free throw. If you want a chance to beat South Carolina, you have to box them out.
Anna,
much easier said than done.
Yes. Anna Wilson into the game for Stanford. Prechtel hits the jumper, showing that range. Had a season-high 12 points against Tennessee.
And so important for Stanford, for their bigs to be able to hit those shots. One, for the points, but also to pull the shot blockers, in particular Aaliyah Boston, away from the basket.
Oh, a little Euro step from Beal. Couldn't finish. A fifth offensive rebound, a putback, and a foul shot coming for Bree Beal.
That's one of the areas where Bree Beal is very good, is attacking the basket. She is big and strong, great frame. So even if she misses the first one, she has a good chance to get in there. Look, surrounded by three Stanford players, still able to get it and finish.
And complete the three-point play. An 11-9 lead for South Carolina as Amihir checks in for the Gamecocks. A break now for Destiny Henderson, who had missed the last three games, as Andrea Carter told us about from the start. Got a couple of full days of practice. And back in there for Dawn Staley. Here is Hull blocked by Beal, and it'll stay with the Cardinal.
Lexi Hull is 6'1", but so is Bree Beal, and able to get her hands on that one here. Just really good defense, and that's where Bree Beal makes her mark. She's known as a defensive stopper.
Tara Vanderveer was very pleased with the way Anna Wilson played against Tennessee. Highlighted it quite a few times to Rebecca, Andre, and I earlier today. As the shot clock fading, Hull got it up off the rim, and that's going to give Stanford another chance here as the rebound caroms off of Beal. We're talking with Tara about, you know, what stands out most about remembering the matchup last season between these teams, and she said that we didn't play very well.
So we didn't screen well. We missed a lot of bunnies, and they certainly did, but able to come through at the very end.
Prechtel, ball fake. Still 10 to operate. Lexi fires and hits from three. Lexi Hull showing the range, shooting it at 41% this season.
Stanford shooting an incredibly efficient percentage right now, and they have to be because of all of the offensive boards and the extra opportunities they have given to South Carolina.
Cook, no. Rebound, Prechtel. And a tie-up is going to keep things here. Stanford will have possession. Well, two of the top coaches in the nation going at it today. We'll examine the connection between Dawn Staley and Tara Vanderveer when we come back. Well, Tara Vanderveer, Dawn Staley, they've been connected throughout the years. You think about 1990, 1992, Tara Vanderveer wins her first two national titles, taking down Dawn Staley with Stanford in Virginia. Then, on the 96 Olympic team, Tara coaching Dawn. Then they meet in the Final Four in 2017 with Dawn Staley's South Carolina Gamecocks winning the title. Then they meet again last season, and of course Stanford defeated South Carolina in the semifinal and then went on to win the national championship. And you can always feel the respect and reverence they each have for each other when we talk to these coaches, Rebecca.
Yeah, without question.
Lexi cups it up and off. Trying to get it back, though, and is able to steal it from Beal. Lexi Hull winning an extra possession for Stanford. Jump, no. And rebound goes out of bounds off of Beal. First meeting in this series history with the teams ranked number one and two. The 62nd time that the AP number one and number two have met in Division I history. That one rims out. Prechtel as it's snared away by Saxton.
You would think it would be a point of emphasis for South Carolina on this possession to get the ball to Aaliyah Boston.
Ami here has it deflected out of bounds, going to stay with South Carolina.
She was completely swarmed. Bree Beal's defender had left her and was in the paint waiting to help.
Last win for Stanford against an AP number one came November 17, 2014. Have that opportunity tonight in Columbia. Ami here goes cross court. Beal, catch, fire, no. And the rebound, Stanford. Rebecca, that's what you're talking about. Stanford willing to cheat off of Beal.
Yeah, they play the percentages, and it's what has given Tara Vanderveer so much success over the years. They'll completely leave a player and go in and help inside.
Oh, that's a beautiful set and a finish from Lexi Hull.
And you're pulling Aaliyah Boston away from the basket. Therefore, there's room for movement and cutting and free shots at the rim, where if she's defending inside, that's a block shot.
Lexi Hull, 9 points now. South Carolina, one for its last 10 from the floor. Here's Boston, swarmed, might have shuffled the feet, no call. Stanford bench wanted it. Cook on the attack. Oh, we have a wedgie. Didn't last long.
Stanford's bigs can shoot from the perimeter, and they can also pass from the perimeter. And when the lane is as open as it is right here, your big comes out, you cut off of her and make the pass. You can't have a shot blocker inside. Boston is guarding the passer.
Another thing, Rebecca, as I watch Stanford's offense, you know, Tara Vanderveer said that Lexi Hull, Lacey Hull, and Anna Wilson are the hardest workers on the team. and I see it. Lexi Hull cuts so hard on the offensive end. That's how she got open for that layup.
So what Stanford does, they move the ball, they're crisp with their passing, things are pretty, they just run really pretty offense. To beat them, you have to make it ugly.
Again on the attack, Lexi Hull with 11 in the quarter.
Beautiful job. If a shot blocker is in your vicinity, you use the rim, the protection of the rim, so you can't get your shot blocked.
South Carolina one for its last 13 from the floor now. Stanford on a 16-4 run. 7-0 more immediately. Here's Haley Jones, little leaner, no. Rebound scooped up by Henderson, foul from Lexi.
Again, you have nice spacing in the lane, and Hull uses the baseline, but right there. If she had gone up on the left side of the rim, that's a block shot for Aaliyah Boston. Instead, she goes to the other side. It gives her a little protection.
Henderson gives it up to Boston. 5-point Stanford lead, under 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. A battle of number one against number two. Ami here just tried to force her way in and lost it. Wilson looking to shake Boston. Out to Prechtel, she gets blocked on a three. Dump down inside, catch and finish for Camilla Cardoso.
Anna Wilson got stuck inside on Cardoso. There was nothing she could do.
The transfer from Syracuse, who Dawn Staley said, they're trying to tell her, shoot, shoot, shoot. She said, I'd rather her taking some bad shots. She just has pass first in her mind, and really they're trying to get her away from that.
She is a very good passer, though.
This time dumps it back to Boston. Boston bangs inside. Cardoso had it swatted by Wilson.
How did Wilson get that block?
That is 5-9 on 6-7. Prechtel kicks it out. Lexi connects on a three. 14 points in the first for Lexi Hull. About a 16-second difference, game and shot clock. Cook doesn't get the roll. Rebound Prechtel, and Stanford can hold for one. A 10-2 run. Wilson, oh, mistake there. Pushed it too early in the shot clock. Lost it. Ami here, denied by Prechtel, and now Stanford will have another chance at a final shot. Wilson with some haste. Jump. The attack, the leave. Jones gets the roll, and that'll do it for the first. What a strong finish to the quarter for Stanford, a 12-2 run for the Cardinal.
Lexi Hull with 14 of Stanford's 19 points, leading the way. Outside, inside, just getting it done.
Well, when's the last time Stanford beat a number one team? How about 2014, November? Amber Orange with the game-tying three, and then in overtime, the go-ahead jumper as Stanford upset number one UConn, 88-86, the final, snapping the Huskies' 47-game winning streak, which at the time seemed really long. Little did we know what was coming. What's at stake tonight? Well, Stanford obviously trying to do something they haven't done since 2014. And South Carolina is already, and this is just crazy, Rebecca, seeking its fifth win against a top 10 team already this season. This is just their 12th game.
Yeah, what an incredible schedule, early season schedule for both of these teams.
And a whistle here as Jones hits the deck. Foul's going to go against South Carolina. Sanaya Rivers called for the foul. Largest deficit South Carolina has faced after a first quarter this season. Just the second time they've trailed after a first quarter this season.
Cameron Brink right now being guarded by Destiny Henderson. Too late for Stanford. They didn't see it.
And Brink, Rebecca, sat the vast majority of that first quarter after picking up an early foul.
And nice block there on Haley Jones.
Shot clock fading. Ho has to heave and hits. Went with the left hand. Oh my goodness. Lacey Ho.
How did she even get it off? Forget about making it.
I mean, it's one thing from the paint to go lefty from the three-point line. And a block from Jones. Here comes Stanford with an 11-point lead. Jones finds Brink. She's rejected. Lexi sets up jump. She got it. On a three. What a start to this game for the Cardinal. The largest deficit for South Carolina this season. It's an 18-2 run for Stanford. And a foul here going to go against Hull, and I believe that will be her second, so that's a big one.
Shot clock going down. It looked like Lacey Hull was not going to be able to get anything off, and instead steps by and launches with the three. Look at her teammates. Holy cow.
I mean, you're right, and that's a big second foul there on Lexi Hull, obviously a critical piece to this Stanford team, 14 in the first quarter. Rebecca, to get that even on the rim with the offhand from three-point range.
That's impressive.
You ever go outside, try and throw a baseball with your offhand?
Or a snowball or anything?
It's not easy.
It's not pretty.
Destiny Anderson hits the step back. I mean, and if you're 50 Cent, it's not easy with either hand. Brink kicks it out. Wilson will fire and rattle in a three. Stanford really shooting it well in the early going from deep.
Yeah, they've been incredible being able to hit from the perimeter. Right now, Aaliyah Boston not in for South Carolina. Yeah, they got to figure out a way to get some easier buckets.
Cardoso is fouled and will shoot two.
Now, Stanford has been so tremendously disruptive on the defensive end. And before that second foul brought Lexi Hull out of the game, as you see Boston come back in, Stanford didn't have a player on the court smaller than 6 feet tall. They are big and they are long defensively. Now they do, with Anna Wilson in because of the foul trouble to Hull. But Stanford can just be take up so much space because of their length.
Now, Lacey has two fouls as well. Typical twin thing to happen. Both get two fouls.
So again, Stanford now gets a little bit smaller. Hamilton in the game. Forget the twin language. It's the twin fouls.
That's right. You know, my mother's a twin. Did I ever tell you that?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, after all these years, it's true.
I'm still learning something new, Ryan.
That's right. Debbie and Dawn, love you both. A 30-16 Stanford lead. Good pressure there. And it's going to stay with Stanford. Tomorrow night on ESPN at 6, Western Kentucky at Rupp Arena taking on number 20 Kentucky. And on ESPN2, the second game of our hoop doubleheader, number 2 Duke opens up ACC play against Virginia Tech at Cameron Indoor in both games. Also available on the ESPN app. Stanford lead. Here is Brink. Handling, finding, believing the cut, and the finish.
Beautiful job because both big players shaded towards Brink, and Believe was able to roll to the basket. You know I love my big-to-big passes, Ryan. So here, screen, hesitate, then roll, Fran Believe. And Cameron Brink finds her inside. The bigs, just a little hesitation by Cardozo, and that allows for the roll and finish.
I mean, how about the move from Brink, too, at 6'4", to handle, spin, and pass like that?
Yeah, she is a really talented young player.
Stanford a plus 6 in the paint thus far. a plus 16 on the scoreboard. Oh, nice hands from Boston. Coming up with a steal.
Go right at Brink. She's foul prone. Go right at her.
Instead, Boston peels back. Boston has it knocked away by Brink. Believe he came with help as well. Here's Wilson.
Aaliyah Boston has been swarmed all season when she catches it inside, but it's just a different level of size and length coming at her today.
Wilson kicks it out. Jones, the spin and the lay. What a move from Haley Jones.
What a talent Haley Jones is as well. Handles the ball so well. Terrific in the mid-range. Can lead their break after getting a defensive board.
I just pictured WNBA general manager salivating watching these two teams play.
Next year's draft, man. Watch out.
Mm-hmm.
Boston, Jones, a lot of others as well.
Oh, nice hands. Henderson coming up with a steal foul against Wilson, her first.
Haley Jones is 6'1", and she starts at the forward position, but she's got the guard handles and just a beautiful job in there, bobbing and weaving between three defenders.
Now, Hamilton coming in here, Rebecca, for Stanford. That's interesting because Tara Vandeveer talked a lot to us about needing to get her in more, wanting to play her in this game, and the importance she thought Jordan would have in order for Stanford to get where they want to go this season.
Well, Destiny Henderson's been wreaking havoc on Anna Wilson, and there she is, wreaking havoc offensively as well, hitting the pull-up.
And that's something I know that really stood out to you from the Tennessee game as well, just Stanford maybe having some trouble handling the basketball against pressure.
Yeah, they had Haley Jones bring the ball up a lot just because of that reason. And here, handoff, go under the screen. You can't do that anymore with Destiny Henderson, the way she's shooting the basketball this season from three and from two.
Ryan Rucco, Rebecca Lobo, Andrea Carter, our entire crew, appreciate you hanging out with us for this number one against number two matchup. Hope you and your loved ones are staying safe and healthy during this holiday season. You see the numbers for South Carolina without Destiny Henderson, and the offense just plummets. Henderson last played November 29th. Beal spins, gets smushed, and Belibi comes up with it. South Carolina in the bonus with a little under 5 minutes to go in this second quarter. The jumper rims off for Hamilton and the rebound secured by South Carolina. Amihir storms in, that hit the dome of Belibi. Gonna stay with South Carolina. We'll step aside. 16 points, Stanford lead here in the second.
Stanford is big and they are long and they are crowding the paint and making it difficult for the team that is one of the best in the paint all season long. There are hands everywhere, there are bodies everywhere. Ooh, what a defensive performance so far.
All right, looking forward to it, Kelsey and Carolyn. Yeah, Lexi, 14 points in that first quarter, none in the second, on the bench now, foul trouble. How about Stanford winning the rebounding battle? That's something that has not happened against South Carolina in two seasons as Boston plunges in for two. Let's check in with Andrea.
Listened in on the South Carolina huddle, Ryan, and Coach Dawn Staley challenged her team to stay engaged the full defensive possessions. He said, we'll block a shot, and then they go get the basketball because we lose where it is. She said, we have to do this with our defense, apply more pressure, and attack in transition.
Well, certainly they've got to find ways to get easy buckets, and the number one way to do that is off defensive boards or steals and transition. Again, beautiful. Beautiful pass to the open lane, cutting through for Belibi.
How about the minutes from Belibi thus far since coming in?
Yeah, she's been really good, and she struggled last year when these teams met in the Final Four, but she has been absolutely solid. Did not play in their last game against Tennessee.
Nice entry pass, and Amir blew the bunny, got it back. Another chance, can't finish, Boston Penn.
There you go. That's South Carolina basketball right there. Put it up on the rim, and if you miss it, just keep going and getting it.
You can really hear the crowd trying to spur some energy from the Gamecocks in this first half. This crowd being treated to number one against number two. Amir off the steal, all the way in, lays it home.
There you go, Drea. There you go. Some easy buckets by getting something going in transition. We've seen that actually a couple times in terms of being able to poke the ball away from Stanford on the perimeter.
Jones trying to shake Beal. Was able to wiggle into a whistle and will shoot two.
Letitia Amir is a talented 6'4 player. She was running the point guard spot when Henderson was out, and just see her there. Good hands, can handle the ball full court. I love her prospects as a pro over the next couple of years. Look at that, look at that wingspan.
I mean, the wingspan, the touch height, the deadlift, just incredible.
You talk about Letitia Amir's physical features and what she can do athletically, but head coach Don Staley told me her favorite thing about Letitia Amir is her mentality, guys. She said her confidence never wavers and her demeanor never changes, and that's why she chose Letitia to run the point guard position when Henderson was out.
I was down in South Carolina a couple weeks ago. I had an opportunity to talk with many of the players on the team, and man, I can't tell you how impressed I was with Amir.
See the last three games, how productive she's been. Over 8 points, over seven boards. Amir, the footwork and the finish. And South Carolina getting a little something going here at the end of the second.
That's what you want if you're South Carolina. A little bit of momentum, a little bit of confidence. Go on a run as you get to the last couple of minutes of this half.
Trailed by as many as 18 on a 10-3 run. Shot clock down to seven. Wilson stops on a dime. What a pass, and believe me, the finish.
But South Carolina's energy has increased, and they have been more disruptive defensively.
Henderson dishes out. Amir back to work. Spinning, can't finish, trying to get it back. Good effort. Tie up, possession arrow, South Carolina.
Anna Wilson with the dribble penetration, and she gets the big to commit, Aaliyah Boston, and that's a hard pass to find. She had to wrap around, but delivered it beautifully.
Rebecca, that's 11 assists for Stanford in this first half.
Wow.
That's a high number.
That's how they play. That's how they play. They are not a one-on-one break you down kind of team. They are a move, pass, cut, score.
Jumper no, rebound break. We saw just four assists for South Carolina. Oh, what a backdoor cut. Jones finishes on a gorgeous delivery from Anna Wilson.
Yeah, Stanford says, all right, we see that you are increasing your defensive pressure, and we know how to relieve it by going backdoor.
Boston, quick turn, cuts between, then used the window beautifully.
And she has multiple defenders coming, and she's as good as it gets in terms of scoring through and over a double team.
10 points now for Aaliyah Boston. Right now, the clubhouse favorite for National Player of the Year through this first third of the season. Wilson gives it up, and Prechtl traveled.
So South Carolina is going to increase their defensive pressure. As soon as you feel the deny out on the three-point line, your job is to go backdoor. And those two have played together long enough to be able to read that and find one another. Beautiful backdoor.
Anna Wilson coming back for a sixth year. Looking like big bro Russell with those last two passes.
Maybe he's looking like her the next time he throws a touchdown, right?
I think so. I want to hear it next Seahawks game.
All right.
foul here against South Carolina.
Not a terrible foul by Hall, because if Jones had been able to post her up in the paint, it would have been an easy two.
Jump inbounds. Brink delivers. Prechtel got fouled by Amihir. Three free throws coming for Prechtel. And that is going to be a tough foul to stomach if you're Dawn Staley.
Prechtel steps out. Amihir fighting over the screen. Oh, she just tripped. She tripped and as a result fell into Prechtel. You can't even be mad at that if you're a coach, right? You just tripped.
Just happens sometimes. Prechtel missed both free throws. Maybe the basketball gods awarding Amihir, feeling bad for her trip.
Prechtel shooting 57%.
Oh, it could be that too.
Such a good three-point shooter and then only 57%.
You know what's amazing? How often that happens in WNBA, NBA, women's, men's, college. How often you see really good three-point shooters who struggle at the line.
So this is what I don't understand about the ball rule. Why not just pass it to midcourt and let her catch it there? The clock's going to start when you touch it. So why roll it? Why not just pass it?
I think because in the air, it has more of a chance of being picked off.
Yeah. Than it does rolling?
Yeah. Because it's still near you in the air. At any moment, it can be picked up. They're going to do it again anyway. Henderson had it blocked. That is some sparkling half for the Stanford Cardinal. Crowd booing, thought there should have been a foul there. No foul called. Just the second time South Carolina has trailed at the half this season. The only other when they faced UConn, and they ended up winning that game. But what a half for Stanford. Tara Vanderveer is with Andrea.
Coach, you all had 12 assists on 17 makes. How do you describe your offensive chemistry that half?
Well, we had a lot of different people contributing, but we're going to have to play better in the second half.
When you say play better, what's key for you defensively to continue to limit the paint?
Well, we got a lot of fouls on us down here. We got to keep people out of foul trouble. We got to keep Lacey on the floor, Cam on the floor. We got to continue to move the ball. We had some really nice plays. We got to rebound better.
Coach, thank you.
All right, thank you.
Well, we'll take a look. This is what Dawn Staley was upset about. Do we think there's a foul? Maybe. Let's head to studio. We welcome you back to ESPN College Basketball. It's the SEC on ESPN. Hope everybody's enjoying the holiday season. Maybe some ugly sweaters themselves. Maybe some nice sweaters. You never know how they feel when they put them on. Certainly the holiday spirit is abundant in Columbia, South Carolina, as we welcome you back to our studios in Bristol. Ryan Rucco alongside the Hall of Famer Rebecca Lobo. What a first half for Stanford. I mean, the way they moved the ball, their offense was just incredible, Rebecca.
Yeah, going against one of the best defensive teams in the country, Stanford was able to shoot 53% in that first half, and a lot of it because they had a clean lane to attack. They space you out. They have shooters on the outside, back cutting when the defense was extending the pressure. Stanford able to just take it at South Carolina with pretty plays in that first half. And then the difference. Look at this ugly, muddled lane with which Aaliyah Boston has to work. There's help inside. There's high hands. There's double teams. She was still able to have some success, but very difficult because of the number of bodies in the paint.
Lexi Hall had 14 in the first quarter. Stanford won the rebounding battle against the best rebounding team in Division I, and you can see Stanford got hot from three as well. As we check in now at Columbia with Andrea Carter.
Thanks, Ryan. I talked to Coach Staley coming out of halftime, and she told me they have to take better shots and be more patient offensively. But defensively, they have a lot of things they have to clean up, but the high post pass, she said, is really causing damage. Look for South Carolina to deny that high post entry this second half.
And that's where they've been able to get the back cuts, where Stanford has, is delivering the ball to the high post and then cutting off of that.
Boston couldn't massage it in. Brink secures the rebound. Here comes Haley Jones. Nice set out of the opening possession for Stanford. Jones couldn't get it to Brink. Taken away by Henderson. Henderson, first game back since November 29th. Saxton got it back, dished it out. Plenty of time for South Carolina to operate. Speaking about the patience that Andrea said Dawn told her. And a foul here against Stanford.
So defensively, South Carolina wants to keep the ball out of the high post of Stanford. Well, when they get it in the high post themselves, it's not so much a back cut as it is a high-low. Beautifully done.
Number one against number two. South Carolina 11-0 to start the season. Stanford 8-2. South Carolina going for its fifth win already this season against a top 10 team. Stanford trying for its first win against the number one team since 2014, and a nice move there from Henderson. Stanford was able to maintain and even pad its lead in the second quarter despite Lexi Hall having to sit on the bench with two fouls for the vast majority of it.
And another block by Beal. That's just a guard, a big guard who can defend inside.
Speaking of blocks, Brink with the rejection and a last hit, Zaya Cook.
So you see South Carolina trying to get some dribble penetration and Cook gets by, but again, the length, the size, the help of the Stanford defense.
Saw Cameron Brink have six blocks in that game against South Carolina last season, as she gets rung around there by Cook, and a foul against South Carolina.
If that foul hadn't been called, it would have been a wide open layup inside.
That's an early substitution too, with Cook coming out. What do you make of that, Rebecca? Littleton in for Cook this early in the third quarter.
Sometimes you just need to help settle your player down, and the best way to do that is to have them sit and watch a little bit.
Violation on the inbound against Stanford. South Carolina ball. Zaya Cook had one of her three games of 25 or more points last season against Stanford in that semifinal matchup. It was 5 for 8 from three in that game. Boston gets blocked by Brink. A chance here for Henderson. She can't hit. Boston the offensive rebound, and a foul's going to go against Brink. It'll be her second, and we'll stay here with South Carolina.
We'll see where the foul comes here, and Aaliyah Boston is relentless on the offensive glass.
Ooh, wow.
She just got away with a push on Haley Jones.
She just chucked Haley Jones, no call. Jumper won't go. Brink lost the rebound. Good activity from Saxton. Littleton bounces to Boston, given space. Dawn Staley talked to us about the value of Littleton from three as Boston connects on a triple.
South Carolina, much like early in this game, getting on the offensive glass and then able to capitalize with the three.
Poked away, last hit Stanford. South Carolina ball went a little juice now.
Aaliyah Boston has extended her range, and here she steps into it confidently, holds the follow through, beautiful.
Henderson backs away, Dishes out. Littleton connects on a three. That's why she's in there.
She hit a couple from that same spot in the first half against Duke.
And now a steal. Henderson will lay it in. And look out. A 10-0 run in the blink of an eye. And Stanford needs a timeout.
Tara Vanderveer has to call a timeout. This is a similar situation to what we saw in the third quarter of their last game against Tennessee.
They had a big halftime lead. Saw Tennessee evaporated in the third. No timeout here. Jump. Can't hit the three. Here comes Henderson. Very surprising. Vanderveer did not take a timeout there. Tennessee outscored Stanford 20-9 in that third quarter on Saturday. Boston will fire short. Rebound, Lexi Hull.
I think Tara Vanderveer is trying to weather the storm until she can get to the under five. TV timeout.
Jump. Around the Brink screen. Brink, the crossover, the drive, and the finish. Tara Vanderveer's faith rewarded. On the other end. Oh, nice play by Saxton to save that. Beal just met a body. It was Jones. Couldn't finish. Here comes Stanford. Two on one. Brink can't finish it over Boston. Down the other end. Left alone. Saxton lays it home. Big four-point swing there. Instead of the lead back to 11, it goes to 7. Crowd is fired up in Columbia. Hull on the attack. Can't finish. A rare miss on the inside from Lexi tonight. Henderson weaving, dishing. Saxton gets fouled. That'll be number 3 on Brink and free throws for Victoria Saxton. South Carolina making its move.
What a start to the third quarter by the Gamecocks. Let's spread out the defense, drain a three, and then when there's some space, steal, score for Destiny Henderson. Victoria Saxton again with the open lane. Things finally easy for South Carolina.
Tonight, a capacity crowd in Columbia, South Carolina. The number one Gamecocks trailing number 2 Stanford in this third, but making their move, and Tara Vanderveer's team again having some issues in a third quarter like what we saw Saturday at Tennessee.
Yeah, not only missing shots like they did against Tennessee, but turning the basketball over. They already have 4 turnovers here in the third quarter alone.
Saxton unable to hit the first free throw, gets the second. Brink out now with 3 fouls. Brink, the leading scorer for Stanford this season. But fouls an issue. Tara Vanderveer talking about that as the next step for Cameron Brink, the sophomore, uber talented.
You see on that possession exactly what Andrea was talking about, denying the high post. Stanford hasn't been able to get it there.
Oh, nice cut. Believe and Wilson, take your pick.
Believe didn't know that Wilson was behind her and that the pass was intended for her.
Believe now with 8 points on 4 of 5 shooting.
But that was a good read by Stanford after the deny of the high post.
Saxton will fire and hit.
Important for her to be able to make that shot as the defense is shading a step towards Aaliyah Boston on the low block.
Jump, double, Prechtel. Oh, quick first step by Wilson, and then what a steal from Henderson. She was beat, somehow came up with a steal, deflected out of bounds by Belibi.
Does this count as a steal before the bucket here? The pass is supposed to be going to Wilson, and believe he steals it right from her. Steal and score, steal and score.
Smelled a bucket, it would not be denied. Boston. Boy, that's what you're talking about, Rebecca. Unable to finish, but uncanny how she's able to work through doubles.
I mean, it is truly remarkable.
Lexi on the drive off of Boston, and plenty of time to operate here for Stanford. I think Boston won the hearts of so many last season with, first of all, her effervescent personality always, but her instant tears on that missed putback in the semifinal against Stanford. You could feel the hearts breaking around the country watching that game, feeling for that young woman in that moment. Jump off on a three, rebound. Beal got pushed, it looked like.
Yeah, she did.
Wow, are they just gonna say that's out of bounds off of Beal?
She got pushed by Hall.
I mean, it looked very clear that Lexi Hall pushed Beal. Well, it's
wow.
Going to be Stanford ball out of bounds off of Beal. Would have been number three on Lexi as well. Blocked by Boston. Secured by Boston. 6-point game. Henderson dishes. Henderson into the paint, finds the cutter. Sexton for two. It's a 4-point game. And another steal from Henderson. Henderson picking pockets left and right. It's down to two.
How about the energy on the defensive end of the floor for South Carolina? They are active, getting it done. Beautiful Destiny Henderson, the drive and the dish. And defensively, she's making it happen. Quick hands, quick feet, quick score. Destiny Henderson has absolutely been the difference here in the second half. Tremendous energy, great decisions. Offensively, knowing when to shoot, when to lay it off for teammates. And defensively, she has been wreaking havoc this entire third quarter. Wow, what a performance so far here.
Let's hear from Andrea Carter.
Well, just as I've been watching Destiny Henderson play, especially in this third quarter, guys, she is so much lower. Her hips are lower. Her shoulders are lower. She's been able to get up under people defensively, and it's caused problems for Stanford. And offensively, her change of pace and speed in person is remarkable.
It's been incredible. 7 steals for Henderson. Missed layup there from Lexi Hull. A 19-4 South Carolina run. They trailed by 18 in the second quarter, 17 after a three from jump to begin the third. And that run has happened since. Beal, she got it! South Carolina has jumped in front. Brink can't force it in. Brink back to work. Boston will have none of it. Henderson speeding to the cup. Had it deflected by Lacey Hull. About an 11-second difference, game and shot clock. What a third quarter from the Gamecocks. Trailed by 14 at the half, 17 after the first possession of the third. Throw it away here, but a 22-4 run over the last 9 minutes following that three from jump to begin the quarter.
Increased pressure on the perimeter has been the difference for South Carolina, forcing those turnovers. The Stanford offense, which was so pretty and flowing in the first half, not in the third quarter.
Stanford can hold for one here to end the third. 3 seconds left. Lacey trying to collect it. Well, the hell ball. Possession arrow, South Carolina. Yet another turnover from Stanford. What a quarter for the Gamecocks, the number one team in the nation. A one-point lead over the number two team in the nation, Stanford. The fourth quarter is coming up next.
What a third quarter for the South Carolina Gamecocks. How did they get it done? Well, they're getting easier looks out in transition, running the floor, defensively increasing energy, steals, and going the other way as well. Just blocking things down, getting it done. Offense that's starting with defense and then easy looks the other way.
A whole lot to cheer about for South Carolina fans in that third. Turn a 14-point halftime deficit into a one-point lead to begin the fourth in this number one versus number two matchup. South Carolina seeking its fifth win already this year against the top 10 team. Stanford seeking its first win against the AP number one since November 17th of 2014.
What are we seeing here is the first possession of zone that we've seen in this game from Stanford.
Meehier barges in, and that's going to be a shot clock violation. So Dawn Staley's team turns it over. Only the second South Carolina turnover in the second half. Hey, tomorrow night on ESPN at 6, Western Kentucky is at Rupp Arena taking on number 20 Kentucky. And on ESPN 2, the second game of our hoop doubleheader, number 2 Duke opens ACC play against Virginia Tech at Cameron Indoor. And both games are also available on the ESPN app. Have you noticed both times I've gone to say Cameron Indoor today, I've said Indorn?
I didn't notice.
A very strange move by me. It's Cameron Indoor, for anyone who was wondering, of course.
And that's another turnover.
It's unbelievable, Rebecca. They had 7 in the third quarter and have already started the fourth with a couple turnovers. 16 for the game now for Stanford. Just 4 in the game for South Carolina. They are a plus 16 in points off of turnovers. Littleton, who has gotten all of Zaya Cook's minutes here in this second half, essentially. Meehier can't finish. Whoa, look out!
So you know, South Carolina, no matter what position they're coming from, are attacking the glass. Haley Jones here. Yeah, trying to box out, but you can't do that. You can't get under her and displace her like that. Great effort trying to keep her off the glass. It's just so difficult against South Carolina.
16 offensive rebounds for South Carolina. Best offensive rebounding team in the country. Boston backs in, floats up, and finishes.
Three defenders in the paint, and she still gets the look.
Lexi trying to get an easy one and does. Good get ahead by Stanford. First points since the first quarter for Lexi Hull. She scored 14 in the first. Beal dumps it down. Saxton surrounded, back out. Little game of pitch and catch, no finish. Lexi off on a three. Jones out of bounds. No. Wow, that's interesting. One official calling it out of bounds, the other saying a foul. Certainly looked like Jones was fouled and a little slow to get up here. Well, that is not what you want to see for one of the best players in the nation. Six. Haley Jones is going to walk off gingerly, sort of flexing that left ankle area.
She was attacking the glass. Yeah, she gets hit there and goes down hard.
Saxton fell on the back of her left leg.
Yes, good sign to see her, though, when she was walking off the court.
So Jones, who's been a menace the last four games, will check out. Prechtl, foul against South Carolina as Belibi hit the deck. And that'll be the second foul against South Carolina in this fourth. There's something else to note with Jones going out. She is an outstanding free throw shooter, and Stanford does not have many of them. So in a close game, fourth quarter, another aspect where they may need her as Belibi jolts in for two.
How about Belibi in her minutes today? Less than 10 minutes so far in this game, and she has been terrific, efficient, tough, aggressive.
10 points, 5 of 6 from the floor. Ami here, gives it up. Littleton, a little too strong. Jump the rebound. Stanford, look at a push. Lacey, dishes. Belibi isolating. Can't finish. Loose ball, back to Stanford.
Look at Boston, look at the pressure she's playing on the perimeter. That's not easy for a 6'5 player.
Jump. Dishes out. Lexi gets fouled. And free throws coming for Lexi Hull. Hey, the annual NBA on Christmas Day tradition continues. 5 games. It starts noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific on ESPN with Hawks Knicks. Then over on ABC, it's Celtics Bucks and Warriors Suns. Nets Lakers on ABC and ESPN, with the day capped off by Mavs Jazz at 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 Pacific. Little Sonya Curry, the mother of Steph, the godmother of Cameron Brink, in the building to watch her goddaughter. We saw her along with Cameron's parents after the national championship game. All obviously very proud.
They were enjoying the post-championship celebration.
They were. And I think we were enjoying the post-broadcast celebration.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Getting free, Henderson lays it in.
Wow.
It's 54 all.
Her decision-making has been terrific.
Oh, nice cutoff there. Boston, Saxton, Henderson, all there defensively for South Carolina. And it's out of bounds off of Stanford.
Dusty Henderson has just made the right decisions, and here comes off tight on the ball screen. But what do you see? She comes off, she's assessing, and then the burst of speed to get to the rim.
Let's get an update on Haley Jones from Andrea.
Saw Haley Jones get a couple extra layers of tape on that left ankle, and she jogged up and down the tunnel, bounced up and down a couple times, gave the trainer a thumbs up, and she is checking back in.
All right, that's good news for Stanford. Thank you, Andrea. Beal, no. She's going to continue to get those opportunities from three.
By design, by the defense's design.
Tied at 54. Number one against number two. Nice move, Belibi with Lexi. And another finish inside for Fran Belibi.
Early on in the possession, South Carolina did a great job preventing those back cuts, but it's just one little mistake, and Stanford can make you pay.
12 points for Fran Belibi. She's 6 of 8 from the floor. Stanford shooting 45% from the floor as a team. Solid number against this South Carolina defense. Boston stepped out of bounds, lost her footing, and a little slow to get up. Now does. We were talking with Dawn Staley about the value of playing these kind of games early in the season. And you know, especially when you look ahead to March, and South Carolina's played such a difficult schedule thus far. And she acknowledged their value, but also said mentally, there's a tax. It wears on you preparing for great team after great team after great team. South Carolina fired up. Littleton loves the turnover. It's Gamecocks basketball, down two when we get back with 4:51 to go. All right, Kelsey, well, certainly some of that going around right now. Meanwhile, this game just outstanding. Stanford led by 14 at the half. South Carolina then outscored Stanford by 15 in the third. Destiny Henderson, first game back since November 29th. 12 points, 6 assists, and 7 steals. And Rebecca, maybe equally as impressive, helping Stewart in offense that's turned it over just 5 times.
Yeah, it's been incredible the way they have taken care of the basketball in this game.
Stanford a 2-point lead, not any longer. Henderson ties it, 56 all. Dawn Staley continues to ride Littleton rather than Cook in the second half of this game. It has worked thus far for South Carolina's. Henderson was able to save it, nearly at steal number 8. Lazy gets absolutely swallowed up by Aaliyah Boston, and Stanford turns it over again.
Destiny Henderson has simply come to play. She has come to play and met the moment, been outstanding offensively here, once again, making the right decision. And then defensively, here we go. But it started, it ended with the Boston block, but it started with Henderson just being so pesky defensively on the ball handler.
And Zaya Cook is in the game for South Carolina, but Littleton stays in there with her as Henderson gets free for the layup. South Carolina back in front. Jones putting it on the deck, looking for an angle. Finds Belibi. Belibi can't finish over her good friend, Aaliyah Boston. Belibi pokes it away. What a play by Belibi, and then a foul on Henderson. That'll be the fourth team foul against South Carolina in this fourth.
Seen Destiny Henderson come off and hit the pull-up mid-range. Well, here she rejects the screen, assesses, and goes in and scores again. The decision-making has been tremendous. And Ryan, as we look at Stanford continuing to have issues with turnovers, 18 in this game, important to remember they return everyone except Kiana Williams, their starting point guard a year ago.
Jones gets fouled, will shoot two. And Rebecca, you just talking about this game ahead of time, you know, one of your points of emphasis was the ability to secure the basketball. How does Stanford handle that against a defense like South Carolina, especially after what you saw against Tennessee?
And you heard Andrea talk about Destiny Henderson. She's smaller than the Stanford players, and that Stanford strength is their length. But when you get a defender who can get under and steal, that is the bane of the existence of bigger ball handlers.
Free throws both good for Jones, an outstanding free throw shooting team, although Stanford just 322nd in the nation in free throw shooting as a team, 61.7% entering tonight. Cook cradles, can't finish, got it back, another chance, put it down in a crowd. Wilson there, held ball, possession arrow belongs to South Carolina.
South Carolina likes to run that set to clear out the right side for Zaya Cook to drive, but instead she came back left and the defense was there to meet her.
58 all, 3 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Ryan Rucco, Rebecca Lobo, Andrea Carter with you.
Rebecca, you had it exactly right. Dawn Staley was just yelling at Zaya Cook to attack. She was dragging her arm saying, cut around the corner and attack that right side.
It's the way the play is drawn up. You clear out the right side of the floor. You have an Aaliyah Boston screen up top so she can give her a little bit of space to go right. Cook decided to go left and got nothing out of it.
Jones behind the back. Oh my goodness! A ballerina! What footwork from Haley Jones! The fake and the finish to put Stanford back in front. 7 lead changes, 4 ties. Boston doesn't get the roll. Believe he can't handle. Nobody. nobody can, and then Stanford finally does.
So this is what Stanford does. When their guards have trouble bringing the ball up against small, pesky defenders, they get the ball to Haley Jones and let her handle.
We saw that in the Final Four last season, where she became the sturdiest hands. Jones, nice dish. Believe, extra feed. Wilson wasn't going to shoot it. Shot clock down to six, and looked like a smart timeout from Tara Vanderveer. Going to try and draw something up here with six on the shot clock.
The Nutcracker, it's Christmas time. Here's your ballerina, Ryan. Look at that footwork.
Well, there's the Christmas list for South Carolina. Yep. Got their quarterback transfer. Spider-Man movie amazing. Now looking for some revenge against Stanford after the semifinal loss in Texas. Three on the shot clock. Anna Wilson's got to go. Realizes it and gets absolutely swatted by Aaliyah Boston.
South Carolina doing a good job of taking away the option. Wilson tries to run the option, and Aaliyah Boston right there saying, uh-uh.
Boy, if you like block shots, you have come to the right place. 10 for South Carolina, 13 for Stanford. The layup won't go for Henderson, but she's fouled, and Destiny Henderson's going to shoot two to try and tie this game.
Hey, Ryan.
Hey, Rebecca.
I like block shots.
Well, you've come to the right place.
I certainly have.
We're glad you're here. Cameron Brink on the bench, so is Prechtel. Henderson, 76% on the season, misses the first. South Carolina, 4-for-8 from the line now.
At a lot of games this season, there have been representatives from WNBA teams there, and one of their questions is, who are the top guards in this draft? I tell you what, Destiny Henderson is certainly making herself one of them.
Wilson around the Jones screen. Our ESPN mock has Henderson going seventh in the draft. Jones, leaner, doesn't get the roll. Nice box out from Saxton. Here comes South Carolina. Down one. Henderson lobs it out. Cook on the attack. And now a settle down from South Carolina. Henderson gets it back, dumps it in, Boston deep, seal in the bucket, Gamecocks back in front.
Smart, patient possession by a veteran South Carolina team, refusing shots they shouldn't take and then making the passes that they should. Pump fake, deliver, score, beautiful basketball, South Carolina.
Now that was interesting. Whistle there after Boston went down, slowed down Stanford. Here come the Cardinal, under a minute to go, down one in Columbia, and an offensive foul against Anna Wilson. That'll be the 19th turnover from Stanford.
One of Tara Vanderveer's frustrations in their last game against Tennessee was that not only turnovers, but bad screens, illegal screens. Yes, that is illegal. And how about Destiny Littleton selling it to make sure that it's called?
Destiny Littleton has played terrific minutes in this second half. Did not play in the first, has played 17 here in the second, and a timeout taken by South Carolina, leading by one, 41.1 to go in the fourth quarter. About an 18-second difference, game and shot clock. What a game it's been between the number one and number two teams in the nation. I don't know, have we seen something similar to this before? Maybe last year at the Final Four. Rebecca, how about, you know, a key on this possession for South Carolina with the basketball and the lead?
I think South Carolina has done a really good job with their decision making, in particular here in the second half. And you might look for some action with Destiny Henderson and Aaliyah Boston. It has worked well. Or you space out the floor, try to get it into Boston, and then let her make the decision out of it, see if the double team comes. And if not, she can go to work.
1 point, South Carolina lead. Fans on their feet. South Carolina trailed by as many as 17 in the third quarter. They trailed by 18 in the first half. Have to get it in, finding Boston. Here is Henderson. Henderson waiting patiently, nursing a one-point lead. Henderson into the paint, step back, is short, rebound, knocked around, Prechtl has it. And what's it going to be? It's going to be a jump ball. Stanford has the possession arrow. They will have the ball down one with 24.7 to go.
I think that was supposed to be a diagonal up screen by Zaya Cook to get Aaliyah Boston onto the low block on the right side, but it did not materialize.
All right, Rebecca, now the other side of things. Stanford with the basketball, down one, 24.7 to go, each team with two timeouts remaining. Where does Stanford go?
Number one, they got to inbound the basketball. We've seen them have issues with that in the past, in particular last year in their matchup with South Carolina. But I would want the ball in Haley Jones' hands. We've seen her in big moments. We saw it throughout the tournament last year. We saw it in the Final Four last year. Get it to Haley Jones and let her make a play.
Well, the reason why South Carolina is in the lead, Destiny Henderson, what a game she's had defensively and offensively.
It's amazing that after 3 weeks out because of injury, she did not miss a beat. She was terrific, disruptive on the defensive end of the floor. I've said it over and over, but she has made the right decision time and time again offensively. When to take it to the rim, when to pull up, when to pass it inside to one of her bigs. She has been so disruptive defensively, leading the charge on that end of the floor as well.
1 point South Carolina lead. Aaliyah Boston's knee being worked on a little bit in this huddle. Stanford has gone 2 minutes and 23 seconds without scoring. Trailing by one, both teams in the bonus. Henderson, a career high, seven steals tonight to go with 17 points and seven assists. Another timeout taken. Stanford will make sure they have exactly what they want for this offensive set. Now just one timeout remaining for Stanford. What's at stake today for the Cardinal? Well, the last time they beat an AP number one, November 17, 2014, against UConn. For South Carolina, they're seeking their fifth win against the top 10 team this season. The number one team in the nation is 11-0 thus far. Got to use that hypervolt in every timeout that you can.
Who's that?
Maybe Aaliyah's, since she was having her leg worked on. Belibi, Brink, Jones, all out on the floor with size and skill for Stanford. After back-to-back timeouts, now the Cardinal will inbound. Lexi Hall in there as well for Stanford. Stanford down one, inbounding 24.7 to go. Hannah jumped the fifth member of the Cardinal on the floor. Here is Jones, has size on Henderson. Dumps it into Brink, turnaround is no good. Rebound Boston, and a foul is called. Nope, a timeout, I believe, taken before the foul. So South Carolina gets the stop, secures the rebound, and takes the timeout.
So smart by Dawn Staley to have Destiny Henderson as the defender on Haley Jones. Assuming Jones is going to get the ball, the toughest defender on the floor. You get up and into Jones. It makes her shy away from doing some dribble penetration, getting the ball into Brink instead. Here, you see Jones catch it. I wouldn't want to dribble on Destiny Henderson. So what do? You get it to Brink, and I think Brink should have attacked the glass. See if you could get the officials to make a call. Or if not, you'll get one of your other players diving in. Great job, great defensive stance by South Carolina. Smart timeout. You think Dawn wants it? I think she does.
So South Carolina with the building ready to celebrate, has the basketball and the possession arrow. One timeout remaining for each team, both teams in the bonus. South Carolina has done an incredible job protecting the basketball tonight. 7 turnovers compared to Stanford's 19.
Steal foul. Steal foul. You're trying to go for the steal right away, and if you can't get it, you've got a foul. What a game.
It has been unbelievable in this second half. Just incredible. South Carolina overcoming a 17-point deficit in the third. And it's been back and forth throughout the fourth. Crowd on its feet. South Carolina to inbound. Another nip and tuck game between these two teams.
Tara Vander telling her team, foul. And then after the free throws or rebound,
timeout.
Call timeout.
Inbound goes to Littleton, being chased, and a foul is called.
Haley Jones should have waited 2 more beats.
Wilson was coming.
Yeah, she was.
So Littleton will go to the line.
I mean, watch Anna Wilson here. She's coming from behind, coming. If Haley Jones gives her 1 more second, oh, she may have.
Yeah, not a lot there.
No.
Littleton, in her career, 78% from the line. This season is just 2 for 4. South Carolina as a team, 5 for 9 tonight. Big ones here. Makes the first.
Number one focus for Stanford. Box out, secure the rebound if she misses.
17 offensive rebounds tonight for South Carolina. Too strong, rebound loose. Who's gonna get it? It's gonna be a tie-up, and the possession arrow belongs to South Carolina. Prescient, partner.
So overlooked. Boxing out and securing the defensive board after a missed free throw.
And so now, Stanford gonna go for a steal or foul again. Lob into Boston. Cameron Briggs not fouling. You had to foul right away. Down 2 with 9 seconds to go. Instead, now there's only 6 seconds left. Aaliyah Boston just 20 for 27 from the line entering this game. So it's not like you're absolutely opposed to putting her at the stripe. Stanford lost a few seconds there.
No matter who it is, you have to foul.
Yeah, and Boston calmly knocks down the first. This is the big one, to make it a 2-possession game. Boston misses, rebound Brink, timeout Stanford with 4.9 to go in the fourth. Stanford has possession, down 3. All right, Rebecca, if you're South Carolina, do you dare try and foul here before Stanford can get a 3 up? Only 4.9 seconds left. It's dicey. Do you try it?
You consider it, but because South Carolina is such a good defensive team, I think maybe you play the possession. However, Stanford is so good at shooting, they'll have 5 players out on the floor who can, including 6'5 Ashton Prechtel, a player who can get her shot off over bigger defenders. I think I would play it out defensively.
All right, see what South Carolina does. Stanford ball out of timeouts. South Carolina, 3-point lead. Stanford 7 for 15 from 3 tonight. Prechtel lobs it into Brink, and a foul given right away. What a smart move. Back to the basket. That's when you give it. It'll put Brink at the line.
So smart, because they were going to Prechtl, who was going to get a look from the corner with her momentum going towards the basket. Smart, smart foul.
And so now, Rebecca, the question is, if you're Stanford, do you miss the second one intentionally as Brink hits the first, or do you think you have time to play it out one more trip down the floor?
Then it would be a heave because you're out of timeouts. Yeah, I would miss.
Thanks to the back-to-back timeouts used a little earlier in the quarter. And that's going to be a lane violation? Is it?
I thought Boston went in at the same time.
Oh, my goodness. Or is it going to be a timeout taken by South Carolina? Let's see. Ooh. Now, it is a lane violation on Beliebe, but did Boston kind of push her in?
Is that reviewable? I don't think it is.
The officials conferring right now.
So Boston starts to lean, and that's what gets Beliebe leaning, but Beliebe's foot touches first.
And so South Carolina has the basketball after the lane violation and then the timeout. Bang, right there. Fran
Beliebe. Shoulders touching?
It looked like maybe Beliebe was guided into the paint a bit by her good friend, Aaliyah Boston. But that is obviously a critical mistake. You see Boston leaning, and then Beliebe goes in.
Oof.
And so just a big-time mistake right there with 3.6 seconds to go. Takes a point off the board, gives possession to South Carolina. They lead by two, inbounding now. Chucking it into the backcourt, playing keep away, and Littleton's foul with just 0.8 of a second remaining. And it's going to take a missed free throw and a heck of a heave for Stanford to have a chance here. South Carolina would improve to 12-0, longest winning streak to open a season since the 2015-16 season. Fifth straight win versus a top 10 team, only team in the last 20 seasons with five before the new year. If South Carolina can hang on, Littleton makes it a three-point game. This free throw to seal it. Littleton, ball game. Ball still has to be inbounded with 0.8 of a second to go. The teams know it's just clerical at this point.
Don't play any defense. Stay away where you can't even accidentally get a foul called.
Just sit on the floor. Brink. That'll do it. South Carolina stays undefeated with a sparkling second half against Stanford. The Gamecocks overcome an 18-point deficit to beat the number two team in the nation. Tara Vanderveer retreats 65-61. The final and the largest comeback victory in program history for South Carolina. South Carolina was tested. They passed the test, and Destiny Henderson, a big reason why, she's with Andrea Carter.
Destiny, your team was down 18 at one point in the third quarter, and you fought back. What does this say about the Gamecocks?
We're disciplined. We got to be dedicated to play our defense. I felt like that's what we were lacking at. Offensively, we wasn't really hitting our shots, but we got to get stops on the other end as well. So I felt like second half, we came out. And then, you know, I tried to be the best defender I can be to help my teammate, to bring back that spark that we needed. So defense was the key tonight.
And this was your first time back on the court in 3 weeks after being out with a leg injury. What did it feel like for you out there?
It sucked. It sucked at first, but, you know, it felt great to be back out here on the court playing with my team. And I can tell they need me. They support me. I support them. So that's all it is to it.
Well, you definitely supported them. You had 17 points, but also 7 assists. How do you choose your spots when you're working on offense to attack?
I got to trust my team. I got to be dedicated to my shot. I know I can score. When the defense collapsed on me, I got open players, basically. So,
you talked about being that defensive spark. You had 7 steals. How were you able to be so disruptive on that end?
Just discipline. Just being dedicated to defense. Defense wins ball games. So, thank you.
Well, excellent performance, Destiny. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Back to you, Ryan.
What a performance from Destiny Anderson in South Carolina. 65-61 win as the top team in the nation remains undefeated. For our producer, Kerry Callahan, our director, Mike Roig, Andrea Carter, and the Hall of Famer, Rebecca Lobo, I'm Ryan Rucco. Coming up next, it's a G League. Lakeland against Santa Cruz is coming up. South Carolina with its 5th win against the top 10 team. First team in the last 20 seasons to do it before New Year. What a win tonight in Columbia.